Good morning students. Today I am going to explain you the HTML part. The HTML part of how to insert image in a web browser. See, we can use to make our web browser look attractive, we have to insert images. So there are many images which can be used in the web browser. But there are three graphics which can be used as a HTML documents. They are three. There is one is called JPG, one is called JPEG, second one is GIF, and third one is PNG. The full form of JPEG is Joint Photographic Expert Group. The full form GIF is Graphics Interchange Format. The third one is Portable Network Graphics. So out of this, the function of out of this JPEG is used for the, it is the most perfect for the photograph. It is the most used for the photograph. It is the best format for the photograph because it uses 1 million of color. Second one is GIF. It is the most suitable for display images designing with the graphics program. And the third one is PNG. That is the image which is used low color and it has more transparency in photograph. Now the image when we use image and document, the tag is IMG. IMG is the tag which is used in the HTML documents. See, there are two types of HTML documents. One is HTML4, other one is HTML5. We are going through the HTML5. In HTML4, we can use graphics, we can use the picture as either in pixel or in percentage, that is in HTML4. But in HTML5, you can only use the pixel. In HTML4, the high and wide of the attributes are used in pixel or in percentage. But in HTML5, the height and wide of the value of height and wide must be used in pixels. So we go through the attributes of IMG tag. The attribute of IMG tags are attributes are number one, height, number two, wide, then number three is SRC. See, this is the most important part of the HTML documents. To insert images, SRC means source. That means from where you are bringing the image file source. From where you can have to bring in the image files. So how you can use? You see here, we can use IMG, SRC. Then whatever you write within the quote mark, there should be the path. You have to follow all the path. You write all the path with the file name. For example, if you use a image file, suppose IMG SRC equals to, so say D drive, then my picture, then slash, then flower dot JPEG or JPG. See, this is the file name. The file name should be case sensitive. Whatever written in the document in the drive, the spelling should be same. We cannot change the characters like small to capital or capital to small. Then this is the called the case sensitive. Is it? Then the source. What is the function of source? Source is that it is used to specify the URL of the image. Second one is height. The height and wide. Suppose This is what I give the diagram of single flower. So this is the height, this is the height and the wide of the images. See, now just come for the height. The height is used to specify the height of the image. The value of the height is used in pixel. For example, IMG SRC equals to say flower.jpg, then given space, then height. Height equals to 120px. And that goes. So here the height of the image is 120px. Next, wide. Wide is used to specify the width of the image. For example, we can use both the attribute in single tag. After the image source flower.jpg height equals 120px, you can write here wide equals to say 80px. So here we can specify both height and wide of the image. The next attribute is about ALT, that is alternate. This tag, this attribute is used when suppose if we download an image but the image does not display on the web page. In this cases, the text, whatever you write with the ALT attribute, that will be displayed in the output, in the web browsers. For example, if you use IMG SRC equals to say flower.jpg, then ALT equals to image of flower. In some cases, if the image is not displayed in the web browser, then when being a mouse pointer here, you will get the text, that is you get image of flower. So if the image is not displayed, then we know that in the cases in web browser, if you got the figure like this and cross mark it here, that means some images are there, but due to some reasons the image is not displayed. In that case, you will get the text, that is image of flower. This is the function of ALT group. Then is next one is about the margin. So margin tag is used to show the margin of the image. Both here also you can use the value of margin in pixels. Again, after margin we'll get 6 is border. This is the border. How much border you have? Thin border, big border, how much? This is border, the image, the value of border will depend on the image. So what value we give? If we give less, we get the less border. If we give more, then we get the more border. Clear with you? So the one more that we left, I'll show you. That is number 7 is Y SRC, then alignment. Alignment. See, suppose this is your web page and this is the image. So this alignment is used to align the image either in top, bottom or the center. The value of alignment is top, bottom and middle. top and bottom, bottom and you can use any value at the top. This is the top. If you use bottom, then image will display it here. If you use middle, then the image will display it here. So this is the alignment of the image. Now, if you go to the books, page number 55, table number 3.1, you will get the descriptions about the SRC, ALT, height and width. Now I'll show you one programs, how to use the programs. Now look at the program. The first tag is the type HTML. In HTML file, the first tag must be HTML bar, doc type HTML, then HTML, head, style type, text, CSS, image. Here see, we have to specify the image height and width between the on style and the off style. See, image border is 4 pixel solid orange. This is the color of the border. Text is white. This is how much? 120px pixel. Height is 10 pixels. H2 text, transform uppercase. If you write the text under the H2, see, you write it here in small letter, but it will display in the web browser in the form of capital letter. Inserting image. So if you write here text from lowercase, then the output will appear in small cases. If we use uppercase, then whatever you write, it will convert into uppercases. Then style close, head must be close before the body part. H2. In the other classes, in class 9 also you can learn about the header text. There are 6 types of headings: H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, and H6. H1 is the largest heading and H6 is the smallest heading. Here I am using the H2 inserting image. This will display it here. After that, I am using mgsrcflower.jpg. So here we can get one image of flower. Image of flower. Next is, see, the border is, how much I'm giving? 4 pixels. This border will come in the size of 4 pixels. Height is 10 pixels and width is 120 pixels. The next text is, our next text is image src flower.jpg. In some cases, if the next image is not displayed, see, here the second image is not displayed, we'll get one crossbar, that means some image is there but it will not display in the web browser. In this case, I'm using here ALT image of flower. In this case, here you can get one tag, that is image of flower. So this is the function of SRC and ALT. After that, body close and HTML close. This you will get in figure number 15, but you will get in figure number 3.1. Clear the two? Now, you can practice at home. You have to do the programs. Page number 56, which is the assignment. Assignment. Page number 56 and practical time. Green copy when you do in your particular books, write the programs, help also draw the output, and whenever ask you have to submit me the program. Submit the notebooks or programs. So thank you all of you. Have a good day. Thank you.